My name is Gianluca Zanna. I was an Italian by birth, and I became an American by choice. Our lives and freedoms are in danger. This is not a dream. If you're listening to this broadcast, you are the resistance.
All systems go.
Welcome to Love, Guns, and Freedom. We're not afraid.
Another Sunday, another show. You're listening to Love, Guns and Freedom on K-Talks 1340 AM and also 104.1 FM. Long time that I've not been on the air. This sucks. Should I do it again? No, let it go. I don't care. It's been many months. The truth is, been many months that I stopped doing this show. Reasons why, I told you last time. I'm sure you remember. I'm tired. I have too many things to do in my life. And sometimes I feel like I cannot do everything. And I have priorities, like my family and also my business. But regardless, we are living in very, very interesting times. I say dramatic times. I would say times that probably we never faced before, at least in this generation. And I think in America in general, or around the world, many countries, like in Europe, something like that could be only compared to World War II, especially for European people, where really the economy and the devastation was a complete devastation to nothing. In America, even World War II, we never really had it so bad, because the point is we don't have it yet that bad. What we are facing, though, is just the beginning, in my humble opinion. We're talking about coronavirus. We're talking about this worldwide crisis that, we can discuss about has been this engineer, has been this part of the plan of the New World Order to create this crisis. The 2020 agenda, after all, it was very important. We've been talking about this for many years on this show. I'll be talking about Agenda 21, Agenda 2030. After all, regardless if this crisis was created by accident, and I doubt it, I truly believe this was a bioweapon created in the lab. It is not just some sort of, some Chinese people going crazy and eating their, bats or some other animals, disgusting stuff. I mean, I'm sure they do that, and I'm sure they get sick. But what we know here, this coronavirus that, by the way, we had coronavirus for many years around, this new strain of coronavirus was a direct source from a bioweapon, a lab. So it's not a typical coronavirus that normally could be, just another little pandemic flu or something like that. So the situation is devastating. Now, reality is, even if maybe the death ratio is not going to be as bad as they tell us, they're using it. And more important, they're destroying the economy. And we can, ignore reality. That's fine. It's your choice. But unfortunately, you cannot ignore consequences of realities. The reality is that out there, regardless where this coronavirus is coming from, regardless if it was pumped up by the media, hyped up by the media, and used by the New World Order to destroy pretty much what we have here, our economy, the reality that the economy is being destroyed. And we are just at the beginning. I mean, Europe, they've been going through this a couple of weeks. I have my mother in Italy that still, after 2 weeks, she's still in the house, in her apartment. She can't get out. She's an older person on top. And lucky that she can have somebody bringing her food. I mean, this is a really dramatic situation. In America, we are just now starting to see the first results. I mean, California, as we talk, is shutting down the borders. It's declaring martial law. New York, I have right now watched just right now videos of armored vehicles, going through New York City. This stuff is real. Now, my humble analysis of all that, regardless where it's coming from, this is being used. This is part of the plan. The New World Order, the globalists, they love stuff like that. Remember, after all, their slogan, their motto is order out of chaos. And this is a perfect chaos. What we have exactly as consequences that's going to benefit the New World Order from this crisis. Number one, destruction of the economy. And when I say economy, people say, wait a second, they have, after all, the big business. Exactly. The economy that they're going to destroy is going to be all the small, medium-sized businesses. the huge corporations like, you know, the Microsoft, like the Walmart of the world, I'm just mentioning some names, they're going to be fine because after all, they will collaborate with the government to preserve themselves and it will become a new creature, like a new shape in a new form. Mussolini used to call it the when you have a corporation becoming, working completely a part of the government is corporatism. So the union between government and corporation will be the equivalent of fascism. So unfortunately, what I see here, what they're trying to do here, and they can do it very well because people are freaking out. And top, you know, now they're declaring us martial law. We cannot even anymore go to work or do anything. Small business will go out of business. They will be wiped out. And I'm talking about myself. This is terrible. We are all together in this one. There is nobody really is going to be untouched. If you live in a regular world, if you pay a mortgage, if you pay a rent, you know, if you have a loan, if you have credit cards, this is going to be very, very tough. If you have a family to feed, this is going to be very, very tough for all of us. So the first thing I'm really concerned, the economy is going to be the first way they're going to put in submission the humanity. Now, more debt, consequence of that is going to be more debt with the private central banks. After all, we remember the central banks are private organizations like the Federal Reserves, and they benefit out of crises like that, out of wars, because every time they print a phony note, in this case a dollar, it's a dollar out of thin air for them, but it's a dollar of debt for us as you know, citizens, because we have to pay back the dollar with the interest. So that's going to be perfect for them. More debt, more trillions of dollars that we're already out of control. I mean, 23 trillions, what do you do with that? Just the interest, it's impossible to repay. So now we have economy, we have more debt. Now we have another agenda from the New World Order that will be very part of this pandemic. It's going to be about the implementation of the forced vaccination. Because after all now, hey, if you are not one of these, you know, pro-vacciners, you must be anti-vacciners, you know, whatever they call anti-vax, you must be one of these terrorists, you must be one of the causes of this problem. You know, they don't look at problem reaction solution, who did that, they don't look at, after all, you know, if you want to vaccine yourself, do it. They don't understand that they found genoma with cancer in most of the vaccines now. The most of these vaccines, they are created by design to sterilize or create even a delay death for many type of genetic groups. So we know very well, I played this many times, Bill Gates said, admitted on video, that vaccines is part of the agenda to depopulate the humanity, the population of the world. So I would be very leery and scary to think now that they found out, right now, a vaccine for the coronavirus. They, by the way, already had a vaccine probably ready to go. And the problem is going to be not just the coronavirus vaccine. It's going to be what they put extra in this vaccine. But they will implement, they will try to implement forced vaccination. That's another part of the agenda. That's going to be with that. Let's not forget, it's going to be the microchipping of humanity. Because after all, they need to know for safety reason, of course, for your safety, wherever you are, whatever you do, and also your medical healthcare. They're thinking that, you know, with this little chip, they can control your health and monitor everything you are going through. That's another part of the globalist agenda. And then, of course, the cashless society. If you think about it, they've been pushing like that, this like that in French, in France, in Italy, already, and people, they were fighting it back. Guess what? Now you cannot fight it back, right? After all, it's for your safety. This cash, this dirty cash, of course, paper, we know that it's dirty, but, you know, they don't tell us, let's go back to copper, let's go back to silver and gold. That would be the real currency according to our constitution. Anyway, they say that all this virus is spread out because of this cash. So they will destroy the system of cash, and they will go through all this cashless society, probably with a chip on your, you know, hand, or maybe this micro card or whatever you have it, so they can track every transaction you do, and you're going to be completely now under their control, like a slave, like a good serf. Every dollar that you gain or earn is going to be back, you know, you got to pay it back through taxes. Now, let's not forget about the other part of this global socialism. It's going to be the kind of free income for all. People think, oh, wow, I'm going to get a free check. Italy just implemented that. That's a complete socialistic you know, a type of tool for the globalists to make everybody slave, like the Indian reservations. They give you a free check just because you decide you follow the rules to be in the reservation. Now, if you are a good citizen, that means a good slave, they will get you a good little check. By the way, that money is not really worth anything anymore, because more money is going to get printed out of thin air. Your savings is going to be worth less. But more important, we know that this money, somebody has to pay him back. Nothing is free. The Federal Reserve, the Central Federal Reserve, will charge us back with the interest. So, yeah, don't get me wrong. I'd rather to give money to us, even free money or, you know, funny money, than give it to other countries. You know, that's one thing, I agree with that. But the problem is that this is not what we're supposed to be as a republic. This is a complete socialistic tool to enslave even more our citizens, our people in America and around the world. So you see how many things that happen here, just with a little bit of virus. Then, of course, the complete destruction of economy. I already told you, you know, we're going to be fine 2 months, 3 months. I don't know who's going to be left here. But at the end, we know that they're going to come also for gun control. We already saw many cities like in Illinois and then other towns in Georgia. They tried to, you know, just because it's coronavirus, that's enough reason to say, let's try to act a new gun control ordinance in our town or maybe in our state. They tried to do that. They already done in the past. Let's not forget what they've done in Katrina. Now they're going to do it, in my opinion, unfortunately, in many other places. So there is so much more, but this is pretty much enough to get depressed. Now, what is the solution? What can we do? Because at the end of the day, I need to figure it out what we can do. Otherwise, you know, let's just jump in the lake and let's take it over. I'm not going to give up. First of all, we decide that we're not going to give up. If we give up, they won. That's exactly what they want. So I think that what we should look into this now, first of all, being smart, try to take care of ourselves first and our families. You know, the government is not going to be your friend. They're not going to help you out. The little check that you're going to get in the mail is going to be worth zero when we go in Mad Max. First thing you should look into that, realizing the most important thing you need is water. Without water, you cannot function after a couple of days. So you got to realize, hopefully it's not too late. Hopefully you already did that in the past. Some water filtration. Something you can get water out of a toilet if you have to, or out of a pond or wherever. So there are a lot of brands out there. I'm not going to advertise anything, but there are a lot of good brands. I'll just give you a couple names, but I'm not, you know, endorsing them. Just I like them because I use them, but I'm not getting paid by them. One is ProPure Water Seals them, and the other one is Berkeley Filters, Berkeley Water System. So get something that works. It can give you pure water wherever you are. Number two, you got to have food. And food, you know, it's not going to last long. The reality that if you look at just the canned food, it's not going to be that something. It's going to give you how many weeks can you last, how many months. So you got to get sustainable food. So seeds, one of the most important things. I would like to invite you to look into, hopefully it's not too late, into sprouting. It takes very little time to learn about it. And you can make the most important, you know, most delicious and nutritious vegetables in 5-6 days out of your kitchen. They have a lot of vitamins, things that normally you need and you cannot get out of a can of beans. That's the reality. Then, of course, another magic word I'm just trying to throw at you, keywords. It's called quinoa or quinoa, Q-U-I-N-O-A. It's a seed from Peru, from the Andes. It's one of the most complete vegetable that has all the amino acids that you can pretty much use to complete your meal. And it's very good. You think about like rice or couscous. It takes a little more time to cook it, but it's very nutritious. It's very also cost effective. You know, I don't know if you even can find it, but if you like it, you can find it. Normally, you can get a pound of organic quinoa for about $4 a pound. You can eat a lot with a pound, differently from a pound of meat. It's going to cost you at least double. Then you eat, what, a little portion maybe. So that's the reality. You got to think about growing vegetables. If you live a little bit in the country, why not? Get some chicken, get in eggs. So the first thing, we got to be ready to have some dignity in our life and sustain ourselves without begging. So food and water. Number three, you already know, you need to arm yourself. But it's not just buying the gun. You know, I've been saying that for years. It's about training. It's about training more than shooting. But shooting is the first part, being, of course, safe with the gun and be able to shoot with others at the same time without shooting each other. So I hope you're going to have a chance, or you had a chance, to practice all that. Have firearms, firearms that they are reliable, firearms that they are, you know, a purpose for each firearms. Your handgun is not, is going to be something, but it's not the solution. The handgun, I always say, it's the arm, the firearm that I use to fight my way to the rifle. Okay? If the marauders come around your home, apartment, or wherever you are, yeah, the gun is better than a rock, but I tell you, you wish you had your beautiful semi-automatic rifle. That's the reality. So, and then, of course, communication. You got to have a way to communicate with your family, with your close friends, and create a network of like-minded people that they have the same ethics, that nobody wants to, you know, steal from each other. You want to support each other, because at the end, all we have is each other. This is my humble analysis. What we can do right now as the first, you know, try to stop this hemorrhage, because they're going to try to make us die quick. We need to survive first. Then, of course, we need to start to understand here that we, the people in America, we're supposed to still have the authority, and we need to find out the responsibles of all this. There are people that they're going around still unpunished, and they're criminals. And we need to start to understand that we've been taken over. All this would have been prevented. We know that CDC kept it away from President Trump, all this information. We want to find out exactly where it's coming from, this. We want to find out a lot of things who is behind this. At the same time, we got to be prepared, because unfortunately, this is not going to be an easy ride. And once the tyrants and this cancer took over our nation, it's not going to go away just because we yell at them. I think we're going to really have to face it one of these days to start to, unfortunately, go and try to chase them out. That's the reality. Now, this is what's about what's happening today in this weekend of March. I think it's the 20th. 22nd, Sunday, even the show is being recorded, and this is, more things are going to happen next week. I don't even know if I'm going to be back on the air next week. I don't know really. My life is changing so much. I want to just tell you, just to go back a little bit, why I left the show, what I've been doing. I told you, I was really, I had a desire to travel and to start to go back into my music career and to into teaching and learning. Self-defense, firearms training, and Krav Maga. So what happened? In January, I had the opportunity to go to France. To France that I had the opportunity to meet a lady, very interesting lady, who also became my music manager. She's my music manager. And I tell you, it's an amazing ride. I felt very honored and humbled. And I have new songs. I'm going to play some of these songs right now for you. They've already been playing some of my songs on the radios, in stations in France, and I had some very famous DJ and music producer that we are, or at least we were, before all this mess, in very close details to close some good deals. So that's why, you know, I had to really, I wanted to do this, and I cannot do everything, you know. So I was in France for a while, or at least for a few days, and I had a chance to meet the people I had to meet and start working there. And I'm very excited. Now, of course, all this is going to be on standby. I don't know for how long. We will see. Meanwhile, I've been writing new songs, and I have really enjoyed the songs. Normally, you know me as my, you know, political songs, songs that I have, you can find on Amazon. Just put Gianluca Zanna. Yeah, I have more than 100 songs. Many of them, they are political, so at least, you know, pro-freedom and things like that. These songs I'm now working, or at least I was working with my new manager, a little more commercial, a little more dance, and I like him. You know, I really think that sometimes we need a break, and I like that direction too. So I had this opportunity that there is this very famous DJ that we are in contact, and he likes some of my songs. So I've been writing new songs, and he's supposed to start to play some of my songs. So right now, nobody's playing anything. Everything's been shut down. But meanwhile, I'd like to play with you one of my new songs. And it's called I Am, and I will give you the one with the voice, but somehow I'm the one talking in the song. I hope you enjoy it. This song is called I Am. You can find it on Amazon, and this is by Gianluca Zanna. And by the way, my new name, when you see these songs on Amazon, is Zanluca, Zanlucka, just to differentiate myself from normally what I do, my more political songs. All right, you listen to Love, Guns, and Freedom. I don't know if this is going to be my last show for now, but whatever. I'm enjoying it and playing it for you. And this is the song called I Am by myself.
You're ready. I am. I am your dreams. I am your hopes. I am your friend. I am your brother. I am your love. You are together. We are the one. I am just me. Your sort of.
Are you ready to get lost in lust? Immerse yourself in a thunderstorm of emotions and passion. Order Gianluca Zana's new book, Perfectly Crazy, 69 Erotic Visions and Love Poems, with forbidden erotic Italian phrases. Perfectly Crazy, by Gianluca Zana. Available all over the world at Amazon.com and www.zana.us.
Here we are. We are back. You're listening to Love, Guns, and Freedom with Luca Zanna on K-Talks 1340 AM and also 104.1 FM. Now, I want to do some playing of some recording. I did record some of my trip. I told you, you know, beside the music in France with my new music manager, I also wanted to pursue, continue, and get better into my studies and certifications of self-defense, and specifically Krav Maga. So I went all the way to Israel to study and certify myself with Master Alan Cohen. That is one of the top names in the Krav Maga. Now, Krav Maga, if you don't know what it is, it's probably the one of the best self-defense system used by military, law enforcement, of course, and the Israeli army. It's very efficient, it's very practical, and it's very, let's say, brutal. Let's be honest, this is not a sport. This is not like about, you know, getting for any type of competition. This is about your life. But regardless, so I don't want to hear about, oh, Israel, whatever you have idea about Israel, this is not a place. This is about me going there, learning and sharing this information. And I also wanted to share with you my little experience walking on the streets of Tel Aviv and also walking on the streets of other cities of Israel where I've been walking. So this is kind of a radio show on the road. And I want to share with you this little bit of a couple of parts, segments that I recorded when I was walking in Tel Aviv. And I'll give you more details after this one and maybe hopefully next week, because it is much more. There's a lot of footage that I got. So it's very interesting. I really enjoyed the experience going to Israel. I think it was a very amazing way to learn Krav Maga. I also am pretty amazed I was able to get all my certifications of all my belts in Israel. And I also got my black belt with Master Alan Cohen. Now, let's be clear. This is just the beginning. I have much more to learn, but I'm very excited. I'm really excited at the opportunity I had to learn. And it was a very also great human experience. I enjoyed it very much. Now, let me play for you this little segment, and then we'll come back. Don't go away. You're listening to Love, Guns, and Freedom. This is Luca Zanna on the streets of Tel Aviv, Israel, broadcasting for you on Love, Guns, and Freedom on K-Talks.
There we go. This is Luca Zanna. You're listening to Love, Guns, and Freedom on K-Talk 1340 AM and also 104.1 FM. Guess what? I'm back, at least for now, when I feel like it. Life moving on, moving forward. I hear the word moving forward. Reminds me of Obama. But anyway, whatever. The point is that right now I am broadcasting my show from around the world. You can hear it. I'm on the street. Not literally. I'm not that on the streets, but I'm on the streets right now in Israel. Exactly in Tel Aviv. And I'm walking around. Little things happened since the last show, last broadcast. We had an opportunity to talk a little bit about things I wanted to do, things I'm doing. And guess what? I'm doing it. Or at least I'm doing my best. Right now I'm in Tel Aviv, exactly, for the night. And I'm here because I'm pretty excited. I'm going to start a couple of weeks of training with my Krav Maga program with Master Alan Cohen, hope I pronounced it right. And I had an extra night to wait. So let me come. Actually, I decided to come a little early, one day early, because I had to do it. And so I spent the night in Tel Aviv. I've never been here in Israel, my first time. And right now I'm on the streets of Tel Aviv. It's about exactly 7 o'clock. Walking around, I took a nap, a little tired. I flew 20 hours from Las Vegas all the way to New Jersey. And then, of course, here, and getting up 3 o'clock in the morning. So it was a nice little ride. And now I'm here, and today I've already been walking around a little bit in the beach of Israel, at least the beach of Tel Aviv. And what I'm trying to do right now is just go look for dinner. Simple as that. So I wanted to share with you these experiences, new things happening. And I thought, you know, it would be interesting to bring the show a little bit, no more in the studio, but a little bit from places that I'm going through. I never really had a chance to be in Israel. And, you know, I don't want to go into politics here. This is for me about now as experience, as a human being, to see something new. As I said, my politics is really simple. I'm an American citizen, and I think we're supposed to play for America. And that's it. I wish Israeli the best. They got their problems. They had problems for probably more than 2,000 years. And I wish everybody the best. But that's not our problem. You know, like George Washington said, you know, trade with everyone, but don't get stuck in weird allegiance or alliance with anybody. I mean, paraphrasing it, of course. So anyway, regardless, you know, so far I had a great experience with people. In Tel Aviv, people seemed very friendly. The driver of my cab was a Muslim, but was a nice Muslim, I tell you, had a nice attitude and seemed like pretty happy. And so far, the people that I met, very friendly, young people, mixed people, a little bit of everything, by the way. I was at the beach, and I was noticing something unusual, I thought. You know, at least unusual for what I thought, in the way I envision Israeli. You know, gay couples. Yeah, hello. Interesting. But anyway, I'm crossing the red light right now. People looking at me a little weird. I don't want to draw too much attention here. After all, you know, not exactly home. I don't speak the language, and I sound like an American with an accent. That's the bottom line. The last thing I need is somebody's trying to look at me like, oh, here we go, the tourist is here. The tourist from America. So, but anyway, I'm looking for dinner now. Then I would like to share with you things that are gonna be happening in the next few days with my Krav Maga training, and I'm pretty excited. And also things that be happening with my music that you know that I didn't tell you yet. But I spent a week in France just a month ago, and guess what? A lot of things are happening. A lot of things are happening. I'm very happy and excited. To, as I said, you know, remember before I closed my last show, my last episode, I told you I was going to go back into music. And bottom line, I'm doing it. I'm serious. I got new songs, and I signed a contract with a manager from France, Nathalie Horn. Thank you, Nathalie. It was a very incredible experience to meet you and, of course, to work with you. I'm very excited about that. I got ready just a couple of days ago, the first French radio stations broadcasting my music, and I will play today, I Am, and also another night in Paris. And I'm really getting to this dance music. I know people know me as Gianluca Zanna, or Luca Zanna as, let's say, political songwriter. You know, my songs, Don't Tread on Us and Wake Up America, and The Minute Man. I mean, I wrote 100 songs, and most of my songs are like that, at least when I came to America. But my original love before I came to America was to write political songs. I mean, excuse me, dance songs. I like dance. I like rock, by the way, also. And I like also romantic music. I like them all. And when I write dance, I don't just write dance, but I also write dance with little romance. So there is always a story, there is always some feelings. It's not just boom, 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 you know, screw that, screw this. It's about emotions. After all, I'm a songwriter, and I don't want to call it my job, but what I try to do here is to transform emotions in music and lyrics. That's what I'm trying to do. So I'm pretty excited about the new things developing in France. And, you know, I'm starting to collaborate with new performers. I don't perform, I write the songs. And, of course, I'm looking always for DJs and artists who want my songs. And I don't want to say anything now because I don't have anything yet completely official, but I'm pretty excited. I'm humble. Things that at least potentially in front of me. So here I am, regardless. I enjoy communicating my opinions, my ideas, my feelings, and also my music. Because I truly believe that, after all, We are living in interesting times, and every one of us should do everything we can to awaken our fellow humans, in this case, our fellow Americans, if you're in America, but wherever you are, we're facing the same problems. Humanity is under attack. The globalist wants to enslave us all. That's the truth. So here we go. Back to Love, Guns and Freedom with Luca Zanna. Right now I'm looking for dinner. Interesting. As I said, I've been up for 24 hours. I just left a couple hours. And it's funny, no? I'm trying to dress low-key, but I guess my boots and my jacket, desert tan, and my black glasses that I'm not wearing, of course, it's night, but you know, I have glasses, so maybe I don't look that blending in. I need to get a little more casual here for Tel Aviv. I'll find out. All right, stay tuned, don't go away. You're listening to Love, Guns and Freedom with Luca Zanna. Ciao. There we go. I'm back on the streets of Tel Aviv. You're listening to Love, Guns and Freedom with Luca Zanna on KTOX 1340 AM and also 104.1 FM. And you're a little crowded. It's Saturday night, after all. I am on Anyway, I'm on my kind of a pretty decent street here close to the beach. Today I had the chance to go to the beach. Kind of a cloudy day, but nice. Stadio, it reminds me a little bit of Italy. Maybe the weather a little milder than Italy. For considering right now we are in the end of February, it's a little milder weather, but still, wasn't bad at all, even without sun. Little misty, a little rainy, not much, but a little bit. So right now, what's going on? Well, my show, Love, Guns and Freedom, is about freedom. It's about love, it's about guns. Nothing changed. But as I said, I would like to put also a little bit of a new input here. How to really, at the end, enjoy life every day a little bit. And simple things, with simple things. Because at the end, if we don't enjoy life with simple things every day, all the things that we're doing, important things, important struggle for freedom, really mean nothing, if you think about it. If we live miserably, our enemies will win, or even better, they already won. So that's where we are. So right now I'm here. I'm doing this for business also. It's not just a vacation, honestly. I don't really look at it as a vacation. I look at it as an experience, and also as an opportunity to learn this new journey that I'm into it, the journey of self-defense. And Krav Maga, I truly believe it's a great self-defense system. It's practical, it's something effective, and can be assimilated without years of this sort of, dojo rules. And martial arts are for dojos, in my opinion. We need a system that is good for real life. And Krav Maga is the answer, at least it's one of the answers. Especially, when you want to start to get somebody that, you want to teach them in 6 months, 8 months, 1 year, how to take care of themselves, you can already give them that opportunity. And what I'm trying to do here is go beyond that. As I said, I'm working with the master, Alan Cohen, and studying under him. And I'm going to have private lessons and seminar, workshop together with other people. So it's kind of my way to go to the next level. Meanwhile, here I am. So you can hear people talking. Looking for a restroom, by the way. So what I want to say, I want to let you know that I have a new song. You always all heard about my romantic songs, maybe. Or maybe more important, as I said, these political songs. Right now, as I said, my new journey with music is about dance songs. And I know many of you, probably people that normally knows me with a political point of view, maybe they don't care much about dance song, and that's fine. Guys, you don't need to care about everything I do, but I'm telling you, this is what I like. And I'm very excited to find my new journey into that, because I truly believe, after all, we all have to follow our journey. And I still, don't get me wrong, I'm still really active into the political thinking and try to understand what's going on in this world and the threats that we face. I mean, there's so much to talk. I like to talk about gun control, what these bastards have been trying to do, what they're trying to do still in Virginia or other states, regardless, even Arizona, they tried, and they're trying. So that's nothing's going to go away. Don't get me wrong. We're still going to face them. At the same time, I thought, you know what? Life is short. Let's try to enjoy a little bit, and let's try to show to the enemies that we're not miserable. And the best way to get back at your enemy is to live well, or at least to enjoy yourself. Okay? So here we are, broadcasting from Tel Aviv, Israel, for tonight. I want to share with you my new song, at least my latest song. Another Night in Paris, that I wrote when I was in Paris a month ago. By the way, I should probably write another one, Another Night in Israel, but I didn't get there yet. So in case I write, I'll let you know. Meanwhile, this is Another Night in Paris, music and lyrics by Gianluca Zanna. By the way, my new artistic name, when it comes down to the dance music, I know, don't laugh, is Zan, Z-A-N, Luca, or Laka, L-U-C-K-A. Somebody gave me that name. And that's fine. So I like to separate my political stuff from my more, let's say, recreational entertainment music, okay? All right, guys, hope you enjoyed Another Night in Paris by Zan Laka.
Tonight. Hit him.
Okay, we are. This is the end of this show. I don't know what's going to happen next Sunday, I must admit it. The reality is, I would like to continue to share with you my opinions, my ideas, my philosophy, my music, you know, but I don't know really what's going to happen here. I mean, we're facing something that, as I said before, in this country, I don't think we ever faced since the Depression. The problem with the Depression was much better things, because after all, people didn't have to face also the fear of this virus. And my really scare now, I mean, scare doesn't really make me difference, you know, I try to be away from fear. But the reality, what I'm concerned, let's put it in this way, that it's not going to be just this virus. This is just something that is distracting us from something bigger. They don't talk much in the news, but it's out there. It's a reality. We have a very tough times now, probably since the Cold War. We never went such in a critical situations with Russia and China. And of course, Iran. But Iran is not just Iran. Okay, it can be a little midget, but the reality is connected to China and Russia. And what I'm really concerned here now, even China start to saying that maybe the U.S. gave the virus to them. I mean, they can spin it whatever they want. The reality, what we can face here, it's a World War III. And sometimes crises like that, they're exactly the first element in a domino effect when they prepare for war to start to weaken a country. If you have a country that is completely paralyzed for 3-4 months, even Trump said, you know, we may have this to face it for 18 months. How can you survive 18 months? People are going to be desperate after 18 hours, without food. You know, if they can't get their Doritos and their diet sodas after 2 days, they're going to have a nervous breakdown. Imagine 18 months. So the reality is that we can face, I want to spell it out, an invasion. That's my concern. Russia and China have now the technology that, unfortunately, our politicians, especially starting from the Clinton, gave it to them. And they have the edge, economic edge. They have a superpower. They also have the numbers. The numbers. They can afford to lose a few millions of people for a disease or a pandemic. They have billions of people there. So, and they have one of the biggest army. That's the reality. Korea would join in. Cuba would join in. Iran would join in. Venezuela would join in. Nicaragua would join in. We would be really in a world spectrum war. You know, Mexico probably would open the doors to make life easier for them. So the reality is we have no idea what can happen. I don't want to freak you out. I don't want to go paranoid. But I tell you, that's unfortunately one of the realities we may face. Solution, I already told you. Be nicer to each other. Network to each other, prepare with each other, help each other. That's one of the things. And start to be having open mind. Don't just listen to the media or the propaganda, what they're going to feed you, what the truth is. The truth, unfortunately, has many faces, and they're never going to tell us unless we want to find it. So meanwhile, I want to say thank you very much for listening. You've been listening to this special edition of Love, Guns, and Freedom with Luca Zanna. I don't know what's going to happen next month or next week, but I'll try to be around. Meanwhile, you can follow my YouTube channel. You can go to loveguntsfreedom.com. It's supposed to redirect to my YouTube channel, and you can find me there with my videos and my other ideas and opinions. Thank you very much. Ciao.